Alright people, we are back into part number 5, and in this video we will be fighting an ice enemy, or should we say ice robot master, Frigid Man. Yeah, you can hear it on the name, just Fridge, Frigerator.
Yeah.
There's no need to think about where that name came from, I suppose. And as we see here, we are actually getting to see a Yetinik, or there are two more of them here. And on the right side, we will just see it in a minute, we were seeing another enemy, and that's a snow gyro. And it hit me and I fell into the water. But we got the A letter from a special name. I'm not gonna tell what name that is, unless you already know it. Anyway, we have a mat with ice on it, and the name on it is Ice Tall. And we also have a Frink. Frink is actually more like a refrigerator, I will say. Not a Yeti. Well, I mean Yeti. I mean Ice Tall. And watch out for the steam coming out here through the holes. And we also tested out the Ballad missile. And it cannot go through walls, but the P-shirt. Or the Mega Arm Cannon. The Arm Cannon can go through. So you just want to kill that snow gyro, and also the Yeti neck. Pick up whatever that's left behind by them, unless it's something, very little important, like weapon armor, weapon energy. And now you want to kill this Yeti neck, and then stand on the edge here to have a safe spot, and time your gems well. As it goes for killing it, you wanna jump just when the door is opening. That's a Frink. And another thing, we have to go down here to kill this Snow Gyro. And there's another Snow Gyro just upside the water. You may just use the tone note if you have that. And I jumped too early. Just time your jumps a little bit. You don't have to jump very high to actually defeat it. And we got some health from Eddie, that's very nice of you. And here, watch out for the ceiling above you. It's very hard, you really, because you also want to kill him as fast as possible. There, I should just have gone to the right. But I didn't get hit there. But here, I will get hit. But he is almost dead now. He, or actually seems more like a she when you look at the head. It's kind of like looking like a woman. And the name of that minor boss is Walrus. Sounds like Frost Walrus or something, I don't know. Probably that's where the name is kind of taken from. And you want to stand as close to the side as possible. Thank you. Also, you can just melt the ice there and dash below it, or slide below it, not dash, but slide. And these are called the shield attackers, of course, too. And there are some of the last enemies you're gonna see in this stage, as it goes for different kind of enemies. Use the Scorch Flame and get 10 bolts here. 10 easy gotten bolts. That means as long as you have killed the Walrus. And we got another bolt. So I'm getting a lot of balls here. And that was another Snow Gyro. And we also have a Frink. And that's the last enemy we're gonna see now until we are, I think, with the two rooms from here. Yeah. Here we only got to think about the steam. And here we got a ice tall. We also have to kill the Snow Gyro over there. There's gonna be one more at the edge on the right there, as you can see, barely. Just shoot it from distance and it won't hurt you. If you get too close, it's easy to die, fall into a pit and die instantly. Okay, we have another room with Talus. You can recover your health or whatever that's needed. You can also get some balls if you want to stay there for long enough. There, we got the last Snow Gyro, and it's time for the boss. And for some reason, I was kind of messing up with the boss there. I didn't die, but I didn't do a good battle against him. Frigid man. I was expecting him to jump up into the air. Usually he does that, like there. And shoots ice. That was like what I was expecting. But he, I think I got too close to him. So if you get too close to him, he might be jumping towards you instead. Because you can easily take him down if you just play carefully enough. Like I'm not doing here, but it works anyway. Otherwise, I'll be seeing you in the next video where we will be taking on some electricity.